It can be super frustrating dealing with really short wires that are coming out of your junction box like this. These things are difficult to work with, they can be dangerous, and they're obviously just super frustrating. So I'm gonna show you three ways that you can take care of these to make them up to code, easy to work with, and safe as well. First things first, let's be safe. Make sure to flip the power off at the circuit breaker so there's no power going to the unit. Once the power is off, make sure to test both plugs on the outlet because sometimes you get some of these plugs that have a switch connected to only one of the plugs. So I'm using my outlet tester here that actually has the voltage reading on it, which I find really helpful. And in this case, all I'm looking for is a signal whether it's on or off. And these are both definitely off with no power, so we're good there. I'm using my insulated Robertson number one driver here because I find that that is super handy for all of these types of electrical screws and works so much better in my opinion than traditional Phillips especially. That's about all I've got. There's no play here. I just do not have enough wiring to do the job properly and it's just really frustrating. So let's take a look at some of our options. We need to decide if the hooks that are on here are actually in good enough shape to continue using, or if it makes sense to, as counterintuitive as it sounds, to snip those off and get those cleaned up and freshly stripped. The US National Electric Code says that you need 6 inches of each conductor available from the point of where it removes from the sheathing back in here. All of these need to be at least 6 inches long. And looking at here, I've got about 4 inches on each of these. Now that's not all. They also need to extend past the outside of the box or the edge of the box by 3 inches. So that means if your sheathing is coming up here, for example, and it's all the way like maybe towards the front of the box, that means you need to have another 6 inches past that, or you can strip that back a little bit to get your 6 inches that way. I'm going to use my lineman's pliers to straighten these out and see what we get. Now I can evaluate and see. These are a little mangled, but you can determine for yourself if you think this needs to be snipped and stripped, or if you can just work with them as is. At this point, let's walk through the three different options that you've got. For two of these, I'm gonna use a WAGO kit like this. Now, you're probably familiar with WAGO connectors. These things have been around for decades in Europe, and they're very popular here in the United States now, especially with the DIY crowd because they're so easy to use and they work so well. The ones I especially like are these guys right here, which are the inline connectors. So these ones allow me to extend my wiring right in line without having to do loops or curves or anything like that. So I can attach one, for example, right onto here. And just like all the other WAGO 221s, they have the transparent backs so I can see right inside to make sure that it's properly connected. And it's really easy to tell if it's seated all the way in. So I'll open my lever, slide this one all the way in, check the back, yep, that's seated all the way in. And then I'll grab a third one for the ground and do the same thing. And that one's all the way in. So we have a really good connection here, it's pretty easy to tell. The next thing I need to do from here is just to extend these with some more wire. So I can grab some Romex. In this case, these are 12-2 Romex cables, which is the yellow sheathing. So I'm gonna grab that and just cut some little pigtails to add onto here. Now it's just a matter of lifting each lever, sliding it into the fully seated position, put the lever down, and you're done. There we go, I've got plenty of wire to work with here. These make a nice solid connection, but I still recommend, just like we do in any sort of box like this, that you kind of guide the bend back in there like that. You kind of create a little Z shape, and that'll give you plenty of room for those wires to tuck all the way back in, and then you still got plenty to work with here. So much easier, very quick, very easy. That's my favorite way to do this and the first way I would recommend. The second way is also using WAGOs, but you don't have to have the inline connectors. We can use a traditional 2-port WAGO connector for this. These 2-port connectors work really well because they work the same. They're just side by side rather than the inline like we saw before. So here, it's recommended that you actually just start with your first one, place it in, help if I did it on the right side, place it in, and pinch it down, and then I'm gonna curve this into place. So I've got the extended piece hanging out over on the side, and then I'm just gonna double check that it's fully seated in the back like that, so we can see that it's got great connection in there, and then we just open up the other lever and slide it on. Again, checking to make sure it's all the way in. I'll double check it inside here. Yep, that looks great, and now we're ready to move on to the next one. And there we go. So now with those three, I've got my hot, neutral, and ground. I've got a lot more room on each one to work with, and I can bend these into the hooks, or I can insert these directly into a side terminal or an edge terminal or anything like that. So much easier to work with. Now, just because I know I'll get a few questions on this one in the comments, yes, you can get a romantic walk through the hardware store shirt and some of the other funny DIY ones that we have in our merch store. So you can be sure to check out the QR code right here for that. Or if you're on a device, you can check out the links in the description below or the merch shelf. Before we get to the third method, I want to show you a couple of things to consider on a box like this because there might be other options that are a little bit easier for you. Now, these steps with the WAGOs, the first two that I showed you, super easy to do, super convenient. They don't cost that much, and it's just something that's just a kind of easy go-to in my opinion. That said, it's always a good idea, especially once your power's off, to just give these things a little bit of a tug and see if there's a little play in here or a little more leeway. And you can feel like this one's just got nothing left to give. That's as far as these are gonna go. And I've seen a lot worse ones than this where they're like half this length. And I've even seen ones that broke right outside the sheathing in the very back of the box. Super difficult. And that's where the inline WAGO connectors are a lifesaver. Another option that you can consider is a lot of times these new work boxes like this that have the nails going in on either side of them, or I guess in this case in this direction, those ones are actually sometimes easy to pry off and cut open, and that way you can get better and easier access to the wires behind there. But if you want to do any splicing or anything like that inside the walls, you have to add a junction box so that it's accessible somewhere else. If you, for example, need to do a little splice up here higher up, then you have to cut in a new hole, put in a junction box and feed those through, connect them, and then feed them onto your new or your existing junction box like this. So it is not up to code to just splice them in the walls and leave them there without a junction box. They have to be accessible. So assuming that you've exhausted those resources and you can't get any more wire available to you, the third method I want to show you is actually using some crimps and to put some crimp connectors on there. So this is a terminal set. And this one comes with all different kinds of sizes and everything. Yellow is what you need if you're going to do from 10 gauge to 12 gauge, which is what most junction boxes for receptacles should be using. And let's say, for example, these are in really terrible shape and you do need to shorten them to get a proper set of wire that's not all beat up. It's pretty easy. We're going to snip this off. Obviously, ground is already stripped, nothing to it. So if I snip this one and this one, then I can just use my wire strippers again. And right here, same thing. Now I've got fresh, clean wires that are not beat up, they're not frayed, they're not nicked, and they're less likely to snap or cause me issues down the road. And with that, I can use my ratcheting crimper here. And I like this one from Klein because it's actually got the three colors right on here that match, the yellow, the blue, and the red. But just to show you an example, I'm gonna use the blue 14 to 16 here, even though normally you would definitely need to use yellow for this. So you can just insert these into one end, locate the blue on here, and as long as you've got enough to work with, I can insert it where the blue is, put it right over the bare wire section, ratchet it down, and then it makes a nice crimp on there. You can see that it leaves the indents and the marks on there, so that's not going anywhere. Then we'll take our pigtail that we've created and then insert that into the other end and crimp that into place as well. There we go. All right, so now we've really easily and very, with minimal volume adding here, we've added another 4 or 5 inches onto the line. So I can do the same thing with our hot wire and our third one, same thing. So you can see this is one of the cleanest ways to do this, especially if you have enough that you can reach. Once again, do keep in mind that if you're going to use the crimp connectors, you want to make sure to use the ones that are the right gauge. If you're doing 12 gauge wire, which most receptacles or outlets use, you need a yellow crimp connector because that's rated for 10 to 12 gauges. If your wires are really short, this may not be an option at all because it's going to be hard to get your crimpers deep inside there. Now, speaking of crimpers, you don't have to have a nice set of crimpers like this to do this. You'll find that a lot of wire strippers out there actually have crimping tools built in, and some of them have the colors labeled right on them as well. So keep in mind, you might be able to use something that you've already got at home to do that. And then these terminal connector sets are really inexpensive, the ones that are ready for crimping. So that's definitely something to consider as far as cost is concerned. And I also love that these are probably the lowest profile and least amount of space as far as what you can add on to the length of your wire and not have to worry about just, you know, filling up that box with the kind of larger WAGO connectors or wire nuts or anything like that. Now with our wires properly extended like this, I can wire up to my outlet. Use the Leviton Decora Edge here again. It's really easy to work with. 1, 2, and 3. And I just wired an outlet, easy as pie. I'll do my Z fold in here. Got plenty of room now. And then fasten it in, get my power turned on, and we're all set. And just like that, we're wired up and we've got plenty of length on those wires. They're up to code, safe, and easy to work with. Now, a lot of people really have no idea about all of the different features that are on their wire strippers that they're using on a regular basis. So be sure to check out this video right here where you can learn about every feature that's on there, what it's for, and which ones you may be missing. I'm Nils with Learn to DIY. Thanks for watching.